I found something from every decade.
Already? You rock.
It's got to be tough to do a movie that where everyone is going to identify with the material, let's say.
Yeah. It's hard. You don't think about that while you're doing it. You just try and think about what's her level of grief at this point. 9 times out of 10, when we grieve or when a human being grieves, it's never perfect. It's painful. It's hard. It's ugly. It's angry. It is denial. It is all those things. And it needs to happen. A person deserves to grieve.
Sure. Well, lightening it up for a second, because mm-hmm. that's the nature of our show. Mm-hmm. Really cool with a movie like this to introduce America to a new, brand new young actor. Mm-hmm. And I thought maybe you could tell us a little bit more about working with this Tom Hanks.
Oh.
He seems interesting.
Tom Hanks, a fresh new face.
Yeah.
A touch immature.
Yeah.
For his age.
Right.
But I think he has some potential
some.
In this business. I mean, there's a lot of competition.
He was very good in Turner and Hooch.
It was a little drooly. That was a dog. There was a dog movie, right?
Right.
Yeah.
And now you're at the level. I mean, of course, we got to know you with the romantic comedies and everything like that. Now you are like the dramatic heavyweight actress in Hollywood. Is it at the point where you walk into a script reading and you're like, Meryl, you can go home. Sandy's here.
Yeah. No, Meryl should never go home. Meryl is up there, and we all bow to her feet.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
After he died, I found this key in my dad's closet.
How can I find the lock that it fits?
What's it got to do with my dad?
I told you I didn't know anything about your father.
This is the single greatest screen performance by a young actor, I think, in the history of cinema.
I think it's such an interesting dynamic you have yourself, you know, so accomplished, such a long career, and then a boy in his first role, and it just coming together beautifully.
It was an amazing experience. He's a very bright boy, and was a giving and taking, like with any professional I've been with before.
How come you don't speak? Are your vocal cords damaged or something? Or did something scare you to death?
Be honest with us for the Daily Buzz. This was an interesting experiment for an actor, or the best gig you've ever had because you didn't have to memorize one line?
A very interesting experience for an actor.
So you've been working in some pretty heavy stuff here for a while, the Hours, The Reader, now this. Any chance we've got like maybe a Deuce Bigelow sequel in the works, maybe like a House Party, sort of change directions a little?
Batman.
Batman.
I want to do Batman. I want to take over from Chris Nolan. I want to do Batman.
Since you are a Jeopardy aficionado at this point, we do the last part of this Jeopardy-style please answer in the form of a question, okay? The city where you're from.
What is San Francisco?
Your favorite school subject.
What is math?
The number of times people have asked you lame questions about Haley Joel Osment.
What is zero?
There you go. A jackass morning show host who you're already 3 times smarter than.
Who is Andy Campbell?
You are correct.